Hello, Pastor Steve Waldron here, New Life Pentecostal Church, Albany, Georgia. Today we're going to look at transhumanism. Now, what is transhumanism? This is the merging of man with machine. Something that was in the realm of science fiction for so many decades is now becoming a very real possibility with nanotechnologies on a molecular level. They're trying to upload brains. Yes, this goes beyond the old cryogenics of the 60s and 70s, freezing people and hopes of a cure and all this kind of stuff. They're actually trying to merge man and machine. The military's actively with DARPA trying to come up with super soldiers, you know, real live Captain Americas, and the wealthy are trying somehow desperately not to die. Well, I've got a way that they cannot die. Repent, get baptized in Jesus' name for the remission of their sins, receive God's beautiful gift of the Holy Ghost, and if you believe that, as Jesus said, you shall never die. Yeah, your body's going to quit, but you'll live forever in a great eternity. And power, oh, you want to be a super soldier? You can get power from on high. God, the Creator, can come live on the inside of you. So transhumanism, Ray Kurzweil does the keyboards, but also very influential, the transhumanistic community. This technology is getting very close. They're wanting to put medical records on chips. People are getting chipped, and this is how they crank their cars. They turn on every light in the house. They unlock their doors with the chips in them. They're trying to increase memory through chips, all kinds of stuff. Transhumanism, making superhuman robotics, energizing DNA, all kinds of things like that. Friend, what we need to do is concentrate on Jesus Christ, pray, talk in tongues, win souls to God, other stuff that may be good to relax your mind as a hobby sometime, but and know that it's going out there. How far will God allow it to go? I don't know, but it doesn't seem like there's any transhumans in the Bible, in the book of Revelation. Transhumanism, you're a different kind, according to James chapter 1, when you become a son and daughter of Almighty God. God bless you. Technology's increasing like the Bible said it would, but God's got the answer. In Jesus' name.